How's it going, guys? I'm your host, Dev04066. Welcome to the Dragon Favor Best Accessories in the Game Guide as of 22nd August 2018. Now, in this guide, we'll be looking at the best accessories available to every single build inside of the game, regardless of whether you're playing an offensive build or a defensive build. This guide will showcase the best equipment that you can possibly use, regardless of whichever build you're using, because all the equipment in this guide covers both offense and defense at the same time. Bear in mind, this is just my opinion. Of course, they are backed up by the stats and the numbers. So you can feel free to have a different opinion from mine. That's totally okay. But without further ado, let's jump right into the guide. Starting off with helms, the best helm in the game, in my opinion, is the Centaur Helm 4. So it has excellent BPD, MPM. It gives a lot of good base stats and gives resistances to energy, water, and fire. 10 each to be exact. And also, I think it looks pretty good. You can get this from the big and small shop after beating the big and small challenge inside the inn at the Age of Time. The next other helm you can get is the Necroparagon Helm 4. So this helm has exactly the same stats as your Centaur Helm. The only difference is that its resistances are different. So the Necroparagon Helm gives light, darkness, and ice resistances, whereas the Centaur Helm gives energy, water, and fire resistances. So depending on where you're questing and which monsters you're facing, you may want to toggle between the two. Both of them are excellent helms and by far the best helms inside the game. You can get the Necroparagon helm from the Blood Moon Challenge Upgrade Shop. So that's it for the best helms in the game. For capes, we have your Groundhog Wings. Okay, you can get this from the Big and Small Challenge, similar to the Centaur Helm. Okay, so it gives excellent BPD, crit rate, MPM, a bunch of good stats, and also 10 to your all resistance, which is extremely useful. The next other wings or cape that you can consider is the Necroparagon cape. So this has exactly the same stats as the Groundhog Wings and exactly the same resistances. So there's no difference between the Necroparagon cape and the Groundhog Wings. It just depends on whichever art style you prefer. Unfortunately, there isn't a picture for the Necroparagon cape yet, but it just looks like a black tattered cape, which looks pretty nice on some builds as well, depending on how you like your character to look. So Necroparagon cape, you can get it from the Blood Moon Challenge Upgrade Shop, and for the Groundhog Wings, you can get it from the Big and Small Shop. Moving on to necklaces. Necklaces, we actually have three options. The first one is the Leaf of Flux Tree. Now you can see here that the Leaf of Flux Tree gives excellent stats all around. The only gripe I have about the Leaf of Flux Tree is that it only gives 6 to your main stats, and there are necklaces out there which give way more main stats than the Leaf of Flux Tree. Other than that, I think it's still a great necklace and definitely one of the contender for the best necklaces inside the game. If you don't have that many base stats, like you're playing with your charisma and luck more, then maybe you can consider using the Leaf of Flux Tree. Nonetheless, it's still a very good necklace, so you guys can consider using this. The second candidate I have for best necklace inside the game is the Skrull Tentacle 4. You can get this from the Primordial Challenge Shop, and its stats are very similar to the Leaf of Flux Tree. The only difference is that this necklace gives more main stats but a little bit less charisma and luck. And I feel that it is slightly better than Leaf of Flux Tree, because I feel that you really do need main stat, and the difference between charisma and luck is about 5, whereas your main stat is about 6. And if I'm not wrong, the Leaf of Flux Tree actually gives one more endurance and wisdom stat, but 1 is really not that big of a difference. But now moving on to our third and final candidate for best necklace inside the game, and also the one that I currently run, is the Unhaloed Death Knight Belt. Gives plenty of good resistances, pretty good stats all around. It gives some resistance to your immobility, darkness, and light, which Tentacle of the Dominion the Leaf of Flux and the Skrull Tentacle does not provide. They do, however, provide an all plus 5, which the Unhaloed Death Knight Amulet does not have. And I feel that the all plus 5 is actually better than the resistances that Unhaloed Death Knight Belt gives. But that being said, the Unhaloed Death Knight Belt gives way too many BPD, MPM, and a bunch of other great stats to simply pass up over the Skrull Tentacle and the Leaf of Flux Tree. So between these three, depending on your playstyle, you can pick any of these three. All three of them are excellent accessories and excellent necklaces for any class that you're playing. So depending on your playstyle, you can pick between the three to see which one suits you best. rings, we only really have two candidates here, and the first one, which is the Unhaloed Death Knight Circlet, is also the one that I'm currently running on my character. It gives excellent BPD, MPM, and a bunch of other great stats as well. In addition to that, it gives negative health resistance, darkness, a little bit of darkness and light resistance, and plenty of good and evil resistance, which is pretty amazing in my opinion. The next candidate is the Tentacle of the Dominion Tree. You can get this from the Dream Space Challengers, and it gives a bunch of pretty good stats as well. The only gripe I have is that it minuses your charisma and your luck stat by 8, and it gives plus 5 all resistance, which is better than the good and evil resistance that the Unhaloed Death Knight Circlet gives in my opinion. It's still a pretty good candidate for the best ring in the game if you don't run charisma or luck on your character. So yeah, between these two, like I said before, for the necklace, depending on your playstyle, you can see which one suits you better, and both of these rings are excellent rings that you can run on any character of any build. For belt, there's only one best belt in the game, and that in my opinion is the Leorilla main belt 4. You can get this from the Leorilla challenge inside the Inn at the Age of Time. It gives pretty good resistances, and on top of that, it also gives some nature resistance, which can be useful against most of the monsters inside the game. You can see here it gives plus 12 to your main stat, it gives 10 to your bonus, crit 10, BPD 6, MPM 6. So overall, a very very strong belt, and definitely a must have for any character of any build, which is what makes this the best belt inside the game. Now for trinket, the best trinket inside the game, without a doubt, has to be the Elemental Unity Defender 9. Okay, I think no, this is not 9. Elemental Unity Defender 15. Yep, this is 15. XP is 15. Alright, so you're going to have to buy the Elemental Unity Defender package along with a little bit of Dragon Coins. It's a very cheap package, so I definitely recommend you getting it. And that's not the hard part. The hard part isn't about purchasing that cheap package. The hard part is actually grinding up all the way from level 1 to level 15, or basically level 1 to level 77, and it takes a total of, I think, over 7,000 or over 10,000 Defender medals to grind up to its final form. And it took me an extremely long time, but trust me, it's worth it. Even the level 1 version isn't that bad. You only get a little bit of extra stats from the final version compared to the level 1 version, but definitely grind it up if you see wars coming up in Dragon Fable. For me, I have my Dragon Fable account for over 10 years, and I don't really participate in wars, as you guys can see from my character page. So what I do is, every day when I have a bit of free time, I just go in and do about 10 to 20 of the Oak Law runs for basically almost the entire duration of my Dragon Fable career, or the entire time where I was active on Dragon Fable, and eventually I was able to farm up the Elemental Unity Defender 15. So you can see here is the best trinket inside the game. It gives plus 5 to your all resistance, minus 5 to your health resistance, a bunch of great stats, and overall a very strong skill called Elemental Unity, which we'll be taking a look at here. It gives 200% damage total with 17 hits, so it synergizes really well with Blade of Awe, and it also gives your enemy minus 30 bonus for 4 turns, which is an excellent, excellent skill. So definitely get this trinket if you can afford it, and it might take some time to grind up, but I assure you it's definitely worth it. The last accessory we actually have on our list is the bracer. Alright, so the bracer, the best bracer inside the game is the Legion Bracer. You can get this from Undead Challenge, and it gives a little bit of crit, 1 to all of your stats, and plus 1 to your all resistance, which can be helpful sometimes, and of course plus 5 bonus if you're lazy to farm that up, or simply don't have the tenacity to beat the challenge. Then you can just buy the 2018 AE calendar and get the Eternal Locket, which also happens to be an artifact for the Epoch class when the Epoch comes out. So I'll assume that this gives extra bonuses to the Epoch class. And the Eternal Locket is a DC tech type, so you can install this for free inside your bank. And I would recommend running this over the Legion Bracer, especially since you will get the Epoch class once the Epoch class releases. But for free to play players, the Legion Bracer has exactly the same stats as you guys can see here. So the Legion Bracer for free to play players, and for those who have already bought the calendar, then run the Eternal Locket. Both of them have exactly the same stats and is the best bracer inside the game. So that's it for the guide. I hope you guys have enjoyed it, and if you have, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and of course subscribe to my channel for more such future content. Till the next time, this has been Dev04066. Peace out.